Hello and welcome to our SolidSteel parametric feature detail bracings and complex assemblies. We have two mock-up frames here, and in today's video we are going to take a look at how we get a wind bracing between these two columns. We could obviously design the wind bracing manually, but that's of course a lot of components with turnbuckles, struts and so on and so forth. So that we don't have to do it all over again, it's easier to draw a complete template once and then load it via the assembly manager. This way the template can be used over and over again. First we click on Import Assembly and select the assembly of our bracing. Here we already see that the option Make Independent is activated. This is right and we can simply confirm the import. Now SolidSteel creates an independent copy of the whole wind bracing and inserts it into our design. We can see the result right here. Of course, it does not fit yet. To make the assembly fit, we select the position assembly function and can then edit the anchor points. To position the imported assembly, all we really need to do is select the anchor points and define where they should be in the new situation. We align the coordinate system by clicking on Align Coordinates and remove unnecessary relations by selecting Remove Relations. As soon as we confirm, we see that the sketch has adjusted to the new situation, but the assembly has not yet. We could now simply click Update and it would update the entire assembly, or we could update only the sub-assembly with our wind bracing. To do this, we select a part, select the sub-assembly from the drop-down menu and confirm. Now SolidSteel recalculates the wind bracing and we can see that all parts have been adapted to the new situation. The bracing now fits very well, it only needs to be connected to the columns. We now do this as usual in SolidSteel and in steel design with gusset plates. With the gusset plate tool activated, we first click on the wind bracing and then on the column to which the connection is to be made. Select the gusset plate from the library and confirm. The gusset plate is added including the bolting and we now repeat this on the remaining locations, here now and fast forward. With this method, we have added a complete wind bracing to our design in a few minutes and we can use it again and again, no matter if it would be in the roof or simply more of them in the walls, or even in completely different assemblies. In other words, we have to create this template once and can use it as often as we like, which means we are saving time, money and resources. That's it for today's feature detail. If you like, subscribe to our channel, if you haven't already. And feel free to visit our website for more information or to contact us directly.